Good evening to the Howard community. I hope that all of you are somewhere safe this evening, and also I hope that you are continuing to stay safe in terms of your health. I come to you tonight to talk to you about the recent bomb threats that have been lodged against Howard University as well as the other HBCUs in our community. So first, my prayers are with all of you for not just your safety, but your mental health wellness. I recognize that this is a very stressful time and a very stressful incident. Domestic terrorism in any form against any people is certainly aberrant, but when it particularly strikes home, it certainly is offensive. We are going to continue to keep you safe and to try our best to make sure that we repel and we continue to push back against anybody who tries to stop what we are doing. What we are doing here is exactly what offends some small fringe groups, but it is also necessary that we continue to do it in the best way possible. I want to assure you that these bomb threats that have been lodged against the university, three at this time, have all come from places that we are not sure about. However, we know that they come from a place of hate. And with that in mind, we have certainly engaged with law enforcement to continue to make sure that we can ferret out the cowards who may be responsible and bring them to justice. Regardless of whether or not that is done, we want you to be safe and we want you to feel safe. So with that in mind, there are a few measures that we're taking that I certainly hope that you would feel comfortable with as we continue to pursue providing a high-class education for you. We have an increased security presence on campus. We have been in touch with not just the FBI and local Metropolitan Police Department, and particularly the 3rd District, but we've also enhanced the resources for our own Department of Public Safety. I have spent time on the phone today as myself with the Department of Homeland Security. And I also want to thank so many of you in our community who have reached out to offer support, and friends of us, members of Congress, members of the White House, and others around the country and internationally. As we move forward, I want to encourage you to do a few things as well, to make sure that you are vigilant as you move about our campus, to report anything that you see that does not look usual. And I also want you to continue to engage with us to provide us feedback of how we can enhance the spaces that you're in. We deployed counselors today in the residence halls, and we will continue to do that over the course of the rest of the week. We've also had under unmarked vehicles on campus and an increased presence from our local law enforcement as well. And those things will continue. There's an active investigation going on. So the specific nature of the threats is not something that we will discuss publicly, but we certainly will continue to acknowledge if any more threats come in to us. And as I close, I want you to remember that the very reason that this university was founded was to fight against the very reason these bomb threats are being made. So we must continue together. And in this month of Black History, we must remember that those who came before us had these fights and larger fights to fight. But the reason that they won is because they did it together. So I ask you to continue to be safe, and I wish you Godspeed.